With each class of organic compounds, we're interested in naming those structures using the IUPAC system. We're interested in the reactions that they undergo. And the third major area of interest are the physical properties. So let's look at the physical properties of aldehydes and ketones. And principally, we're interested in two aspects: their boiling points and whether or not they're soluble in water. And impacting both of these considerations are whether or not the structures can form hydrogen bonds. So let's look at aldehydes and ketones and see what kind of hydrogen bonds they can form. Here's the structure of a typical aldehyde and ketone. Neither one of these structures has a hydrogen attached to the oxygen. Got lots of hydrogens present in both of these structures, but up here on the double bond O, there's no hydrogen. And what that means is that if I had a pure sample of an aldehyde or a ketone, and when I use that word pure, it means that it's not contaminated with alcohols, there isn't any water around. If I just have the aldehyde or if I just have the ketone, they can't hydrogen bond because there's no H on that O. And if they can't hydrogen bond, then that's going to impact their boiling points. Alcohols, you know, can hydrogen bond, so aldehydes and ketones don't boil quite as high as alcohols. They boil higher than alkanes and alkenes because the C double bond O is polarized a little bit, and that increases their boiling point somewhat, but they never reach as high as the alcohols. Let's look now to see whether they can hydrogen bond with water. Structure of an aldehyde, here's water. Well, the water can now furnish the OH. And so yes, aldehydes can hydrogen bond with water. And here with this dotted line, I've shown that hydrogen is bridging two oxygens, and this water molecule through hydrogen bonding helps to pull the aldehyde into solution. So low molecular weight aldehydes are very water soluble. And the same thing with ketones. All I really need is that O, because water furnishes the H. And again, hydrogen bonding can take place. This particular ketone is called acetone. Acetone can mix in any proportion with water because of its high solubility due to the formation of these hydrogen bonds.